I'm Jennifer Katcher, teach biology here at Pima Community College, and today we're going to do a lab called Comparing Antacids. And you can see we have a variety of antacids here, and this lab gives us a chance to look at how we can affect pH in living systems. We're going to have some simulated stomach acid and see how adding antacids affects the pH of that stomach acid. It also gives us a chance to explore the process of designing and testing a hypothesis. So the first thing that you're going to do is look at a list of active ingredients for each antacid. So rather than me try to show you all the labels on here, you'll look at the document online that has information about each antacid. You'll notice that some of them are liquids and some of them are tablets. Some of them are brand name and some of them are generic. And so as you look at that list, be thinking of some questions and think about what you might want to compare. Would you want to compare a liquid to a tablet with the same active ingredient? Would you want to compare a generic versus a name brand? Things like that. And you're going to come up with a hypothesis how you expect each of the two antacids that you compare to affect the stomach acid. Do you expect them to work equally well? Do you expect one to work better than the other? You want to specify this in your hypothesis. And you'll notice too on your worksheet that there's a space for a prediction. And a prediction is like a hypothesis, but it's much more specific. So for example, if I say I'm going to test Alka-Seltzer versus Pepto-Bismol tablets, and I say I expect that the Pepto-Bismol tablet will increase the pH of stomach acid more than the Alka-Seltzer will increase the pH of the stomach acid. So one thing that will help you to develop good hypotheses and good predictions is to be very specific about your independent and your dependent variables. And so you'll remember that the independent variable is the thing you, the researcher, are independently varying. And in this case, it's going to be the type of antacid. The dependent variable is what you expect to be affected by your independent variable. So if I change the antacid, then I expect it to change the pH of the stomach acid. So in this case, my dependent variable would be the change in pH of the stomach acid. So on your lab worksheet, you'll see that there's spaces for you to fill out what are your variables, your independent variable, your dependent variable, and then some standardized variables, things that you're going to hold constant throughout the experiment. And what you're going to do is actually design an experiment that will test your hypothesis. And when we think about scientists, we usually think about them doing science, like, you know, handling chemicals or doing field work. But a lot of science is actually designing experiments. And in this particular experiment, you might spend more time designing what you want tested than it will actually take to do the testing. So I want you to think carefully about how you would design an experiment, what would be your variables, what would you be holding constant as your standardized variables. And once you have that, then you're going to submit that to your instructor, and your instructor will give you additional instructions on how to receive the data for the experiment that you design. But take plenty of time, give plenty of thought, ask questions that you have about designing the experiment.